Hello there. Okay, so Hank?
Yeah?
We're here in the new James Arnold Taylor JAT Studios.
Yeah.
And the microphone's on.
Yeah, testing 1, 2.
Stop that. It's a new microphone, by the way. New SC Electronics 2200 microphone, which is great. We'll get into that later.
Yeah.
We're in the booth of the new James Arnold Taylor, or JAT, as I'm called by my fans affectionately, J-A-T, JAT. JAT Studios for the JAT cast, the James Arnold Taylor podcast, which is actually called Talking to Myself, but we kind of name it that because of, you know, JAT and all of that. And we're kind of on the inside. Well, it's a nickname. Anyways, it's a nickname for the podcast.
Yeah.
And so you are my engineer. See, I'm saying these things, Hank.
Yeah.
Because some people may be new to the show because I haven't been on, I haven't had an episode in a very long time, which we'll get to. We'll explain all that. But so you are my engineer. Introduce. You know what, Hank? Why don't you just introduce yourself? Why don't you tell people who you are and what you do?
I'm Hank.
What do you like? You're like, you're nervous. Like you don't know what to say.
Well, you know, I mean,
you always have something. You come in, you interrupt, you're my engineer for the show, and you're just supposed to kind of engineer things, but instead you just kind of come in and get in the way, and you smell of onion sandwiches, and...
Yeah.
Okay, so, why are you nervous?
I don't know, you never, like, done, you never, like, said, you know, go ahead and talk and say whatever you wanted, so now I don't know what to say.
Okay. Well, then I should tell you to talk more often.
What?
Nothing. And Billy, you're here. Oh, yes, Mr. James, I'm right here. Yes, you're right behind me. You're actually kind of close to me there. That's, it's, you know, guys, it's, the booth. See, here's the thing, everybody. Hello, welcome, by the way. Welcome to the James Arnold Taylor podcast. We'll get to the intro in a second. But the thing is I'm here in my brand new studio. I've built a brand new recording facility in my home. I had a really lovely studio before, and I had the opportunity to build a studio. We'll talk about all that in a minute. Anyways. I have this wonderful booth, and it's like, you know, it's like 7 by almost 9. It's a big booth. And yet, Hank, stop that, is right here, right next to me. Would you stop? Like, on the same microphone. Okay, he keeps leaning in every time. And why do you keep saying, yeah? Okay, no, stop it. And Billy... Yes, Mr. James, yes, right here. No, okay, stop it. You didn't need to jump up at the mic. You guys, there's enough room in here to have multiple microphones and set up.
Oh, that's a good idea. You should get someone to come in and hook up the multiple microphones today. That'd be good.
Well, you're the engineer, Hank, so you would be the guy that would set up the multiple microphones.
What do you mean?
I mean, you're... Oh, gosh. Okay. You know, anyways, you know what? Okay, you're all cramming in, and Mr. Announcer Guy, you know, is going to come...
Yes, James.
Oh, hi, Mr. Announcer Guy. Hi. You are right here on my microphone as well.
Yeah, man, I thought it'd be cool.
No, okay, look, guys, what I'm saying is this... I have a beautiful new studio, big, lots of space. There's a control room out there that's huge, and there's room, and there's an art studio connected to it. All this space. And I have a nice big booth, but you're all in here with me. You didn't need to be, you see?
Yeah.
Okay... But I appreciate it. We're all in here together, warm and snuggly together. And onion sandwich. You've been eating onion sandwiches again, haven't you, Hank?
Yeah.
Okay, so stop that. And Billy, too? They're actually quite delicious, you know. Okay. Mr. Announcer Guy, you wouldn't eat an onion sandwich, though, before coming on and doing the show right on the same microphone as me, would you?
No way, man. That'd be rude.
Thank you.
I eat garlic.
Okay. Oh, I'm in trouble. Anyways, you know, why don't we, let's do something different and actually introduce the show before going on and on and on. What do you say?
Yeah, man. Okay. I mean, if that's what you want to do.
I think that's an excellent idea, Mr. James, sir.
Okay, great. We're going to now, so Mr. Announcer Guy, see, you're already here. I like it when I call you in and then you're,
yes, James? That was a terrible impression of Mr. Announcer Guy.
Okay, well, you know, look.
I mean, you should be better at it since you're him.
I know. See, I try to do my impressions of you guys when I'm me. It's like when Bugs Bunny would do Daffy Duck as Bugs Bunny doing Daffy Duck, but it was Mel Blanc did all the voice. It's really, by the way, that's pretty cool, you know? That is a cool thing that Mel Blanc did. Anyway, okay, so I try to emulate. I am nowhere near, but I try to emulate the people. So anyways, Mr. Announcer guy, you go over there. You can just stand over in the corner of the booth there.
Right over here, Matt?
Yeah, just right over there. And you don't need to come in and open the door because, you know, the truth is that's a door, that sound effect of the door. Billy, can you cue that?
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay, play that. Okay, that right there, that's a sound effect I use for the door. There's not an actual door that sounds like that. You wouldn't have a door that sounds like that in a studio.
I thought we were going to go and, like, introduce the show.
Okay, we are, but no. So, Mr. Announcer, you're over there.
Yeah, man.
And... So stay over there, and then I'm going to go, oh, Mr. Announcer Guy, like we normally do on the shows. See, it's been a very long time, everybody, and I'm trying to get kind of back into the swing here and get all these guys back. They have been, well, their stories will tell. Anyways, so let's just get on with it. So, oh, Mr. Announcer Guy.
Yes, James.
See, that was it. That was nice. I like that. That's what I'm used to. That's what the people are used to. How's it going?
I'm doing good, man. How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm great. I mean, we're going to do another season, a big batch of shows for the James Arnold Taylor podcast because people like the show.
If you say so, man.
Hey, Hank, come on. Okay, so Mr. Announcer Guy, you've been doing well?
Yeah, man. I've been working on my tan.
Your tan? Oh, you look, yeah, you do look very tan. I think most people kind of, I picture like you, big, you know, burly announcer guys that be nice and tan. Like you're sitting out at a pool all day and then you wait for the calls to come in and do your big announcing and stuff.
Yeah, man, if only.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, well, anyways, are you ready to introduce the, it's the second episode of the third season of the James Arnold Taylor podcast because we had an episode that came out earlier this year, and this year is almost over now, because of my good friend Victoria LaBaume and her wonderful book that she did, and that you all can find that. That's episode 51, season 3, episode 1, but it's episode 51 of the entirety of the James Arnold Taylor podcast. This one would be episode 2 of season 3, but it's technically episode 52.
You're just confusing everybody now.
Yes, I have to agree, sir. I mean, that's right.
Okay, guys, thank you. So anyways, let's just cue that music. Let's get Jerry the Music Man in here. Jerry is our old-time radio guy that plays music for us and cues the music in the other room. Yeah. Hey, Jerry the Music Man!
Yeah, James!
Can you cue that music for Mr. Announcer Guy to do the big intro for the big show of episode 2, season 3, but episode 52 of the...
You know, just get on with it.
Would you stop? Don't yell at me.
I'm just saying.
Okay. All right. He's got a point. Well, he's got a point.
Yes, he does, sir, Mr. James. Thank you, Billy.
Okay, Mr. I'm sorry. I'm so confused. Mr. Jerry the Music Man, can you cue the music?
I'm just waiting for you, James.
All right. Thank you. Go ahead and cue that music. And should we have new music? Should we have new music for the show or just keep the old music? I don't know. We'll decide. I don't know what you're going to do. Whatever you cue, go ahead and cue it. And there you go. Oh, that's nice. Okay, great. All right, Mr. Announcer, do your thing.
It's about time.
What's that?
Nothing.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, it's the James Arnold Taylor podcast, talking to myself, the Jackcast. And it's a new season, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah, man. Mr. Sir, Mr. Announcer, Sir, man.
It's just Mr. Announcer Guy.
Well, thank you, Mr. Announcer Guy, sir.
Boy, this is going on a long time.
Would you guys just let him do his thing?
Thanks, dude. On today's show, Jat's gonna fill you in on all that's been happening in his life. Boy, it's been a while. So now here he is, the same guy that's doing all the voices you're hearing, including this one, James Arnold Taylor!
Hey, hey, Mr. Announcer Guy, well done. Well done, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You got it, man.
You're in good voice, Mr. Announcer Guy. You sound great.
Yeah, man. It's the new digs.
I love the new studio. It sounds great. You sound great. Even Hank sounds great.
Yeah.
Well, maybe.
What?
Nothing. So, thank you so much, Mr. Announcer Guy. We're going to have a great show.
Yeah, dude.
Thanks so much.
I'm going to go now.
And there he goes. And then we cue that other music. Well, that music hasn't changed. Never will change. I love that music. This is the little theme to the James Arnold Taylor's podcast, Talking to Myself. We call it the Jatcast. Sometimes we call it the Jat Fellowship because that's kind of our group here. Now, here's the thing. As the guy that is Jat, first off, I want to say thank you to all of you that have stuck around hung in there and waited for new episodes of this show. I gotta tell you, there's a whole story, and pretty much, I think that's pretty much what we'll do here this episode. We'll just kind of tell some stories, talk about life and what has led up to the recording of new season and new episodes of this show to kind of prepare you for the season, kind of prepare me for the season, because I don't know what I'm going to say or do, in a show. All of this is extemporaneous. It's all just right off the top of my head. People ask me, do you plan this show out? No, I don't. All the voices coming out of my mouth and my head, they just come out as they come out. I don't know when Hank's going to talk. I don't know when Billy's going to talk, when Mr. Announcer Guy's going to talk, Jerry the Music Man, Reginald, Don't Call Me Reggie. Reginald, Don't Call Me Reggie has not been on the show in a while, although there hasn't been a show in a while, so how could there be him on a show? Anyways, so let's bring in Reginald, Don't Call Me Reggie.
Yes, James.
Ooh, wow, you sound, boy, you're big on that mic.
Yes, I have my own microphone.
You're doing like a handheld. What is that? That's kind of a neat thing.
Right.
So Reginald,
stop it.
What have you been up to?
Well, I've just been enjoying myself. The fact that I have not had to deal with all of you, the likes of all of you.
Hey, come on now.
Just kidding. No, I've been reading a lot. I read a lot of
What do you read? Are you like those cheesy romance novels?
Stop it.
I needed to pick something that was like so ridiculous that I knew you never would actually read. But those Harlequin romance novels, that's what you do?
Stop it.
Okay, all right. You got to come up with a better comeback than stop it.
Stop.
All right, well, that's you shortened it. That's better than something, I guess. Anyways, Reginald, don't call me Reggie. It's good to see you, and maybe we'll bring you back in here in a little bit. You can ask me some, questions and stuff. But for now, I'm going to kind of give us a little blanket intro to what's been going on and everything, okay?
Right. Very good. All right, James. I'll be in the other room reading my Harlequin romance novels.
Okay. All right. Oh, there he goes. So, yeah, Hank?
Yeah?
Are you still really going to just be standing right here hovering over me with the microphone?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I would prefer it if you didn't. I need a little space here. Why don't you and Billy? Yes, sir, Mr. Jim. No, Billy. I'm just saying, why don't you guys go into the control room? Because in this, now, for those of you that haven't seen the new James Arnold Taylor Studios, go to my Instagram account, JatActor, and scroll through back to, a few months ago, and you could see the whole building process of this studio. And I took you on a tour. There was an Instagram I did the other, like a month or so ago, where I did a live tour, Instagram Live, and I went through the whole studio and everything. You check it out. But this studio is kind of my dream studio. And a lot of hard work put into this, a lot of money, a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of energy, a lot of blood, sweat, and tears, and emotion going into building this studio that I'm in right now. And I'm in the booth. And it took a while to decide to do the podcast in the booth or in the control room. Because in the past, I would do the show from the control room of my old studio. Because it was just easier. I'd sit there and I could look and I could see everything going and just all that. But this studio, I've got a big glass window. I've got thick walls. The walls are like 18 inches thick in places. It's just really cool. It's soundproof. It's amazing. So guys,
yeah.
Why don't you go in there, especially on the part where I say it's soundproof, go in there and you can watch and record from there and make sure everything's recording.
Okay, yeah, that's a good idea. We're going to eat, Billy, you want to eat some onion sandwiches?
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Hank, I love an onion sandwich.
Okay, guys, yeah, do that. But no, actually, no. Don't eat onion sandwiches in my control room, please.
How about peanut butter and jellies?
Peanut butter and jelly?
Yeah, how about peanut butter and jelly?
Oh, yes. I don't know. I don't really want sticky stuff on the desk and everything. What do you have to eat? Can you just go and just watch while we work? I mean, I'm not eating while we work. In fact, that's the thing. So as a voice actor, I'm all over the place, guys. Sorry, but I'm getting back into this. I'm getting into the rhythm. I'm finding my groove. And you know that that's what this show is about. This is the one place where I can just kind of talk and tell you about my life and tell you about things and just talk. So as a voice actor, you spend your time in little padded rooms talking to yourself, looking through panes of glass into a control room where the director and the producers and all the people are, and they are always sitting there eating in front of you. It's the most frustrating thing because I'll be in the booth here, and the booth is, of course, dead quiet, and the microphones are right here, and they get this beautiful compression and all this stuff on them and all this, and then you hear... you know, and your stomach growls, and then everybody's looking like, oh, and they start laughing. It's like, yeah, well, I'm watching all of you eat, because that's what happens when you're like recording a animated show or a radio commercial, a TV commercial, a video game. They're all in the control room directing you and doing all that, but they don't have to worry about talking. So they're sitting there snacking. They bring like fruit platters in. They're all eating and they're, you know, just enjoying themselves while you're stuck in the booth starving. And so anyways, so guys, just go in there and just watch me do the show.
Okay. Sounds kind of boring.
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Hank, sir. Yes, it does sound kind of boring. Hey, Billy. Oh, no, sir. No, Mr. James, sir. No, I mean, it doesn't sound boring at all. In fact, I really enjoy watching everything that you do, and that's why I'm so proud to be your intern.
Okay, all right. Okay, so that's Billy the intern. For those of you that are new to the show, that's Billy the intern. He helps me out here because he wants to be a voice actor, and so he's studying. So, you know, he gets to kind of hang out and be here. And Hank is the engineer. Mr. Announcer Guy is the announcer of the show. You heard Reginald, don't call me Reggie. Reggie is kind of the snooty British fellow that comes in and poses big interview questions to me at times. And he's just kind of a counterpoint to me. And then who else we got? We've got Jerry the Music Man plays all the music. We've got different announcers that come into the show. We've got Bob who reads the emails and stuff. And we're going to talk about that because, you know, some of you or many of you may know there is no place to send me emails currently. But that doesn't mean that we still can't answer your questions and stuff on the show because there is still my social media on Instagram. There's a Twitter account and I have not been using that as much. But anyways, okay. So let's just, okay. It's like, what are we, like 18, almost 19 minutes into the show, and I'm finally just like, you know, that's how it works. Now, I was always a big fan of these shows that would do like a pre-show kind of thing and then kick into the show. So I like that. I like it because I'm taking you behind the scenes. You're kind of hearing all the stuff that goes on with me and all the characters here. And then we figure it out, and then I find my little message for the show and I kind of go on. But here's the other thing that's interesting to me, that's fascinating to me, is how many of you enjoy just kind of hearing me go on and on. All right. Hey, guess what I'm getting? Oh, you know that sound, right? If you're new to the James Arnold Taylor podcast, one thing you need to know is I encourage healthy living, good breathing, lots and lots and lots and lots of water. Hydrate the body. So you'll hear that little in my cup there, and then I'll swig water. I encourage you to get yourself a nice big glass of water while listening to this podcast and sipping it throughout the show. Look, obviously I can't tell you can or can't do something, but I'd prefer you to not have coffee or soda or, you know, anything like that. You could have tea. That's all right. As long as it's a good tea, it's not, you know, but I prefer you to try with me a glass of room temperature water. Nice, you know, get a nice purified water, something nice and clean and good for you, and sip that through the show. That's the whole thing. Even though I'm a little crazy, and yes, 20 minutes in, I'm finally calming down. That's my ADHD in there. That's me being, you know, wacky, nutty. This is who I am. This is me talking to myself. That's why the show's called Talking to Myself. But at the same time, I'm somebody that really does try to live kind of a mellow, a non-stressed life. And this is a place where I kind of goof off and have fun doing voices for you. And I'm amazed at how many people enjoy listening to it. And I'm very, 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 pretend I said very 1,000 more times, grateful and humbled by all of you taking the time to do this. So thank you. Excuse me, I had a little tickle in my throat. So let's start with, well, here, let me give you something. Now, most of you know that I'm a Christian. And even though this is Talking to Myself and it's a pop culture thing and I do voices and I talk about my career and all of that, I also talk about my faith because I can't help but talk about my faith. I don't try to push it on anybody. I want you to see how what I think is a semi-normal, I'm semi-normal, well, my family's normal, Christian living in this world today and how I look at things. And so what I do is I try to open things up with prayer. I try to open things up with, let me turn that light on there so I can see better because I'm an old man. I try to open things up with God's word. So listen to this. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's Romans 15:13, one of my favorites. I love that scripture. I love giving that to people when they're having a rough time or something. I say, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing. Ah, more water. That's good water. so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. So that's me in a
nutshell, baby.
That's what I believe. I believe in God. I believe in God the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Holy Trinity, all that crazy stuff, man. Dig it, baby. That's what I'm about. So I do talk about my faith a lot, and I can't help but bring it up here. So if you're into that, great. If you're not, you know what? Stick around. You might find it's interesting to know what someone else believes that believes differently than you. And I have to lay it out there. Why? Because if I didn't, well, I know what I believe and why I believe it. And that's what I say here. And I know more than I want to know. And that's what I'm asking of you. So if you don't believe the way I believe, hang out. You know, take a listen to what I'm having to say, because I'm not really just going to be sitting here talking about the Bible or my Christianity. I'm going to talk about other things, but I do start things that way in my life and in my day. I start my day on my knees. When I get out of bed, I try to roll out of bed onto my knees and say a prayer of great thanksgiving. You know, I had something happen to me this last year. It was actually a year ago, pretty close to within just a week or two of this, that was a very kind of, you know, bummer thing happened, a big bummer thing happened to me. And it was very traumatic, and it was very hard to deal with. I'm somebody that's kind of what they call an empath. I empathize with everybody, and I get hurt when people say hurtful things about me and such. And there was some stuff that I didn't enjoy, and it affected me in a way. It's kind of one of the reasons why I'm not doing a lot on social media anymore, and I'm not doing all of the podcast even anymore. It was kind of like, what do I say, you know? Because I just want to entertain you guys. I want to have fun. And I want to talk about my faith. I want to talk about my life and how I live, because I feel like it encourages people, and people from the letters and comments I get from all of you in social media and such. I know that it encourages people. I know it encourages a lot of people. I know by the fact that there are thousands and thousands of people listening to this podcast whenever it comes out, that it does encourage people. So hey, thank you so much. But anyways, I had what they call vertigo, which is when the room is basically spinning around and around. And you can get it various different ways. I got it from stress, and I got it from a lot of junk that went on last year around this time. And it took 2 months for the room to stop spinning for me. And that was very scary. And we had a lot of doctor's appointments, a lot of, you know, tests, and a lot of things going on. But I will say this, you know, when people go, why are you a Christian? And when I say, know what you believe and why you believe it, because I know what I believe. And what I believe is I'm a Christian. Why do I believe it? Because God has been so apparent in my life from day one. Now, I did not grow up a Christian, okay? I did not grow up in a traditional Christian home. I think we would have called ourselves Christians, but we weren't walking the Christian walk. We weren't living the Christian life at all. And a lot of New Age religion, a lot of different belief systems there that culminated into just kind of like, yeah, whatever, man. And nothing, you know, directly educating me on what Christ was about. But it does not mean his hand wasn't on me, and there wasn't a calling in my life to find out who he was. So I seeked him out. I seeked him out. That's exactly what I did. I seeked him out, and there he was. Sorry, I was doing that voice in a cartoon today, but I can't talk about that. Anyways, so I sought out God, and I said, dude, are you real? And he said, yeah, dude.
He said, yeah, man.
Because Mr. Announcer Guy is kind of like the big guy, right?
I hear everything. I'm omnipotent, man.
Yeah. But he's proven himself to me, and he's proven himself to me over and over and over again. So I know what I believe and why I believe it. Because why do I believe it? Because every time I ask God, show me that you're here and that you love me, he does. And that's, you know, that's the coolest thing about my faith. And that's all. And then I'll move on to other things. But it all intertwines with why I've stopped doing the podcast. It intertwines with why, you know, all of this stuff. Why I am who I am, why I do what I do, why I say what I say, why I live the way I live. It's all about my faith, you know? And so he shows himself in so many wonderful ways to me that I, you know, that's what I believe. I believe it because of that. So There you go. But so this last year, 2 months of the room spinning, basically, you know, every time I would get up, every time I move, I couldn't bend over. We were in the process of doing some things that were very physical around the house where I had to be picking up things and moving them and bending over a lot. And I couldn't do that. And that made it incredibly hard. I had to sleep for 2 months sitting up upright, you know, like straight up upright, because if I leaned my head back at all, the room would start spinning again. So, you know, vertigo is, again, there's different reasons for it to happen. Mine was a loose crystal got loose, and the reasons crystals can get loose are various things. I did have a bump to the head that probably contributed to it, but there was mainly the stress factors in my life and all the stuff. I take things, I don't want to say I take them personal. I take things very seriously. And when even one person wants to come down on you in a negative way, or come down on any of you, or come down on me or my family or anything, or my friends, it affects me. And I, you know, I try not to have it affect me as much as it does, but it does. And so I had to really kind of take a break, because again, I had this pretty serious. Now, I had to work throughout the whole thing, and I did. I recorded Ratchet and Clank. I recorded Johnny Test. I recorded so many different things that were being made at that time with this vertigo. And, it, you know, not easy to do when you're having to, you know, go, whoa, you know, and throw your head around and stuff. It was very challenging. And I thought, well, is this my new normal? And I was talking to God, because that's what I do too, man. Like I say, I get on my knees every day. I start with all of that. And that was the point of the story, but I was trying to get to, which I'll get back to. I was talking to him and I'm going like, dude, because here's the thing about God. You can talk to God however you would talk to your best friend, okay? You can talk to God however you would talk to your worst enemy. You can, because if you don't believe in him, you can talk to him like that. You can say, hey, dude, I don't believe in you. But you can say, you know, I like to call him Pops, Papa, Lord, God, Father, you know, just Jesus, Yeshua, Emmanuel, all the names. I use them all in various forms and different times, but sometimes I'll just go, God, Pops, help me out here. This is hard. And so many people right now are going through things that are hard. I think the culmination of it too is the world was spinning out of control. The world is still kind of spinning out of control. You know, there's so much going on and it affects me, because I just don't want people to be hurting. I don't want you to be hurting. I don't want you to be in a position where you don't know what's next. And for me personally, it was because I was, you know, I was attacked personally, and it really bummed me out. And I really, really, really prayed for all the people that were doing that, you know, because I know they're not people, you know, people can't help themselves. It's not My job is not to judge anybody on that. My job is to pray for people and to hope for the best, and to walk away when there's no, you know, shake the dust off your sandals, as the good book says, when you can't get any further in a conversation with somebody. So you then have to walk away. And so I took a break from it all. But during that time, I was praying to God, and I was like, you know, help me out here, man. Because I don't want this to be my new normal. It was very hard on my family. It was very hard on my wife. It was very hard on my daughter. It's hard on my friends. My friends, boy, oh. You know, you find out who your friends are when you're hurting, when you're sick, when you're having a hard time, when you're dealing with mental struggles too, you know. The people that stick by you, why, God bless them. And I want to be that for everybody. I want to be that for all of you. And that's why I had to come back with the podcast, because I know that there's many people out there that need this. And, you know, I got to tell you, I don't think of myself as all that much. I think some people could take what I do when I talk about what I do and such as bragging. But it's always, I've said it on the show before, when I go like, I got to work with, you know, this person or that person, and I got to do this show, and that was so cool. It's not me bragging. It's me going, can you believe it? Like this little kid, that did wacky voices in his bedroom on a Radio Shack tape recorder and, you know, wanted to be a comic and a performer from like day one, got to live his dream, you know, and beat the odds as a high school dropout, as somebody that grew up in a house that was full of drug abuse and violence and manipulation and mental abuse and all sorts of bad stuff, and then beat those odds and got to do what he loves. And it was some of that craziness probably that gave me the abilities to do what I do, to do what I do. But if you followed that. But it was also the grace of God. It was only the grace of God that got me out of it and said, yes, I'm going to help you. But so he's always gotten me out of it. And so a year ago at 2 months of the room spinning and going, God, help me out here. I was having some tests done for the vertigo. And in order for them to test it, they got to put cameras on your eyes and you're in the dark and these cameras just go over your eyes, the goggles, and you're just in pitch black and they record your eyes, the movement, because they can track where the crystals are loose and within your ear. So in your inner ear, you've got all these different little canals. You've got three different canals there. And there's like this little pocket that holds these calcium crystals in your ear. And sometimes due to a blow to the head or whiplash or something like that, those crystals can get loose and go down into the canals that have like a thick syrup type fluid in there. And when those crystals go, they tell the brain that you're moving even though you're not. And that's what causes spinning. So it's very disconcerting. It's very scary and it's just no fun. And I'm sure more than one person listening to this has experienced it before. And all I can say is, God bless you. My heart goes out to you. My love to you. And I'm sorry, because it is a terrible feeling. And I don't wish it on anybody. And I don't mean to bring it up to make anybody, get concerned about that stuff. But you have to understand. See, for me, it helps me to understand what's going on. And it helps with like anxiety or just understanding. If I understand what's happening, there's a crystal loose in there and it can be put back into place and then it won't spin anymore. Great. But for 2 months, they couldn't get these crystals back in my ears. So then it was like, well, is it that and all of that? So I'm having these tests done. I'm lying on this table. And I had to lay down. I hadn't laid down in 2 months. I had to lay down and it was scary to lay down. And the young gal was so sweet. And she was just this young technician, the audiologist and technician of all this stuff. And she does all these hearing tests. She does all this stuff. They put the things in your ears and all that. And the last test, she had this great little Southern accent. You said, okay, Mr. James. And then she called me Mr. James. Okay, Mr. James, we're going to take you and you're going to lay back now. And we're going to put this in. This is the hard part, but you just stick with me. And God bless her. So sweet. And so they put these tubes in your ears and they put hot air into your ear. They blow hot air to heat that fluid that is in those canals to induce the vertigo so they can videotape your eyes and see what's happening and see if they can track down why and where and how and what's going on. So for several minutes, they induce this vertigo. And so you are spinning like on one of those things in the NASA things. That's how you feel, but you're not moving. And I'm going, this is hard. I mean, I'm like, tears coming out of my eyes going, okay, and she's so sweet, give me, and she's trying to get my mind off of it. So she'd be like, give me a male name that starts with A, now B, now C, and I'm going through Charlie, David, Eric, Frank, you're just naming things and just the room spinning and I'm just, and I got through it and through it, I was feeling like God was going, it's okay, hang in there. Hang in there. And she's going, it's okay. Hang in there. Hang in there. And I'm saying, it's okay. Hang in there. Hang in there. And it's spinning around. And she goes, we're almost done. We're almost done. We're almost done. And then she's got to do the next ear. No, no. And then, and so she then says, okay, we got what we needed. And I go, well, that's good. She goes, yeah, because if we didn't, I was going to have to blow cold air into your ears then and start the whole thing over again. I was like, oh, thank you, Jesus, that we didn't have to. But after that, then I had to go in and sit in the waiting room and the doctor couldn't see me for like another hour. And so I'm sitting in the waiting room and there's a very serious disease called Meniere's disease, which one of my favorite, all-time favorite musicians, Huey Lewis, has. And it just breaks my heart. I've met Huey. I've worked with Huey on things. Thanks to my friend Scott Sava and the film Animal Crackers. Huey was, Huey Lewis's music is very important to me in my life because my wife and I, our first dance at our wedding was a Huey Lewis song back in the 80s. And, he's just so great. So it broke my heart that he has this disease called Meniere's disease. And I was hoping I did not have it as well. And so I'm waiting an hour and I'm sitting there in the waiting room. And I get this peace because I felt balanced and I felt like God said, you're done.
It's over. You're going to be fine. And I went, okay.
And then I do what I do sometimes, which, because I don't hear from God, I'm not one of those guys that hears that. And when I say he said, you're done, it's over, it wasn't an audible voice. It wasn't Mr. Announcer guy.
You're done, man. It's all over. You're going to be cool, man.
It wasn't that. I'm just saying, I'm saying, like, that was the sense, that was the feeling I got in my soul, in my mind, in my heart. I felt as though God was, you know, his Holy Spirit speaks to me there. And I just got peace, you know, and I felt like it was like, it's okay. So I don't really hear from him the way that some people do. I don't know. I've never been that type of person, but I get those senses. And so everything felt better. And I go in, but I'm still scared. And the doctor finally comes in and he goes, well, it's not Meniere's disease. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Whew, man. And unfortunately, my wife and my daughter, they dropped me off. They could not be there in the room at the time because they had an appointment that they were at. And so it was just me. You know, this had been months of dealing with this. And I was like, thank you, God, it's not that. And so he says, you know, I hate to say I told you so, but, you know, I figured it was that in the past they were diagnosing the wrong canal in your ear where the crystal was. And they were, from the tests that we see, that looks like they were. And so he goes, I'm going to send you upstairs right now to physical therapy. They're going to do a couple of maneuvers on you and try to get those crystals back in place. And I already knew at this point that it was over, that I wasn't going to, I just had peace, but I was like, okay, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, doctor. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And I go upstairs and I meet the fella, and he's Australian, mate. And he's going, I'm going to walk you through this. He's going to be great, mate. You're going to be fine. Put your head back. You know, he was a great guy. And we did these maneuvers, but again, I didn't get the spinning. It was fine. I was okay already. And since then I have been fine. Thank you, Jesus. And talking about it now, you know, I go back and forth because this is very, 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 very personal. You have to understand, I am giving you all my very, very personal life here. But that's been kind of one of the things I do here. But why do I do that? Because part of the JAT Fellowship is to share with you and to help you. Because a lot of you don't have a parent or a mentor or a friend or a peer that you can just talk to and you can share experiences with. And I can be that for you. And if I can be that for you and I can share experiences and I can be a mentor to you through this podcast in some way, then, you know, there it is. There it is. So through it, when I was going through it, when I was in the thick of it, I said, Lord, please, if you can take this away from me, I will promise to be joyful the rest of my life. Not happy every day. I can't promise to be happy every day because, again, as we've talked about on the show, there's a difference between joyful and happy. Joy, having joy in your heart and happiness. And, you know, there's been a lot of reasons to not have joy in our hearts over the last 2 years. 2 years, by the way, can you believe that all this junk has been going on? But I said, if you get me through this, I promise I will do my best to have joy. And he got me through it. He honors the requests and the prayers of his children. And I'm one of his adopted children into his home and his family and his kingdom. And so I asked him, and he provided a miracle for me. And, you know, maybe it was the test and the hot air blowing in, and maybe that dislodged the crystal that was in my canal. Maybe the maneuvers they did do something. Maybe it was that. Maybe it was miraculous. Who knows? God uses all sorts of things. God uses science to heal people. God uses, you know, medicine to heal people. God uses the will, the human spirit. There's so many ways that God heals us. But I know that I received a touch from him and a promise from him. And in that, I am ever so grateful. And so I try to hold joy in my heart every day, even on days where it's hard, even on days where I'm sad, even on days where I'm just not up to par. I try to remember the joy of the Lord will be my strength. I will not falter. I will not faint. He is my shepherd. I am not afraid. The joy of the Lord is my strength. And I want to encourage all of you that all you got to do is go, hey, dude, I need you, and I need you in an unselfish, selfish way, in that
I want to be okay. Now, it doesn't mean that, you know, he just going to heal everybody of every illness and ailment and stuff, because there's reasons for all of that that go beyond us at times. And I can't explain all of those things. I certainly can't. And that's not what this show is for or about. It's for me to tell you my experiences and why I believe the way I believe. That's it. But to encourage you through my stuff. So even if you don't believe in the way I believe, know that you can always seek it out. There you go. And maybe you have stories and miracles of your own. And that's awesome too. So that was 2 months of my life. That was a lot going on. But man, do I enjoy all of you listening to me. And do I enjoy this show and doing the voices and all that, which... You know how it works if you listen to this show. I do the voices at the beginning. I do the voices kind of at the end sometimes. But in the middle, I talk about some stuff. And we talked about some stuff here. And I told you a little story. And, you know, after all of that, I built this studio. And we had some changes in our personal life and such. And thought, okay, let's build this studio and really make one that is soundproof and really solid and really the kind of like the studio of my dreams. And so that's what I did. And I love it, and I'm grateful for it. And so in the room next to it is my art studio where I paint. And so I am trying to do more painting and such, but I've also been working on a new screenplay. And I wrote a movie a couple years back, and some of you that follow me may remember all of that. And I wrote that movie, and that movie is still written and waiting to get made. And there's been a couple of times where I started to make it. I've shot some scenes. I've contemplated putting those scenes on my YouTube and Rumble channels to just show people, you know, like what it was about. But yeah, you know, I probably won't, because I may make the movie in its full entirety someday. But the reason I didn't finish that movie was, well, I finished the script, but it just, you know, it's not the right timing for that one. But this new one that I just wrote, I just finished writing yesterday. I just typed the end. And now I'm in, you know, that was the first draft. Now I'll go back through. I'll change the draft. I'll make another one. I'm working with a buddy of mine, Matthew Buds, who is a filmmaker, a talented fella, and just a dear friend. And we are working on that together. And so that's taken me away from some of the painting, but I want to get back to my painting. And I want to get back to this podcast for y'all too. Try to put one out, I mean, at least once a month, if nothing else. But, you know, maybe back into the old heyday of where I was doing them weekly. But it just depends. You know, it's very hard right now, because the things I would want to talk about, I go, you know, I don't know. I can't talk about what I do for a living that much because I signed so many NDAs. I can say this. I'm working on some great new content that is not my content, that I'm, you know, a hired voice actor for, on several different new projects that will be coming out, I'm sure, within the next year. And I'm really excited about them. And when they come out, I can talk about them more. And I'm working on all sorts of stuff. I'm still doing, you know, the Fox voice, thanks be to God, you know.
Animation Domination, coming up next on Fox.
A lot of people may not know that's me. That's me. I've been doing that voice for a long time. I'm blessed to do it. You know, so a lot of new stuff coming down the pike, as it were, and been recorded in this brand new, beautiful studio. And I'm so excited for all of that and for all of you to hear all of that. And I've been recording on these beautiful microphones. I've got, so SE Electronics is the maker of the SE Electronics 2200. And I love this mic. And that's what I'm recording on. That's the new microphone of the James Arnold Taylor podcast. SE Electronics 2200. Beautiful mic. Go to my YouTube channel and check out the video where I show you this mic. It sounds fantastic. And I'm here in the booth right now recording on it, and I love it. And I really recommend it for anybody looking for a mic. And it's, you know, it's like about $300. That is an amazing price for a microphone. This isn't like a paid announcement for it. It's just, I love the mic. I'm very grateful to them for sending me one of these mics, and thank you to SE Electronics, but also please, everybody, check this out. I mean, the proof is in the pudding. You can hear it. If you're listening to this podcast, you know how great this mic sounds. And so I love this mic. I highly recommend this mic. I've had other mics on in the past, but this now is the new official microphone of the James Arnold Taylor podcast. I should get Mr. Announcer Guy to come in and say, hey, Mr. Announcer Guy!
Yes, James?
Can you say, now the official microphone of the James Arnold Taylor Podcast, SE Electronics 2200?
You want me to do it like that? No.
No, come on. You're getting sassy with me.
Yeah, man, it's what I do. Yeah, all right. Jerry the Music Man, give me some music.
You got it, Mr. Announcer Guy.
That's cool. You're listening on the official microphone of the James Arnold Taylor Podcast, the SE Electronics 2200. Check out SEElectronics.com for more. Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Thanks, Mr. Announcer Guy.
You got it. I'm going to go now. Again.
Oh, there he goes. The SE Electronics 2200, a beautiful microphone, about $300, and has a windscreen on it and a shock mount. And man, oh man, do I enjoy this microphone. I love microphones. I love all the tech junk. I really do. I could talk about all of it for a long time. I had a buddy of mine, Jack Daniel. Go to Jack Daniel VO. He is a very talented voice actor. And he does all those trailers. He's got that great, in a world, you know, he's got that big voice. And he was over here. He came and visited with his lovely fiance, Wendy, and they came out for Thanksgiving, and I did all the Thanksgiving. You know, I make everything from scratch here at the James Arnold Taylor house. I do. I make all of the food. I do all the cooking. I love doing all the cooking. And my wife loves that I do all the cooking. And I make it all from scratch. And so they all came out for Thanksgiving, and we had a great time, and we talked about voiceover and stuff. But then I got him in here in this booth, and I got him on this mic, and he was like, wow, this mic sounds great. And now he's like, I got to get me one of them too. So, you know, if you're looking for a microphone, that's all I'm saying. And again, not paid to say that. I'm just telling you out of the goodness of my heart. Okay. All right, check it out. Should I tell you what time it is right now? It is 1:42 in the morning. Normally I would record these things during the day, but I was like, I should just record an episode. I was feeling creative. And you know, when you're feeling creative, try to do something creative. If you're somebody that is creative, shifting gears here for a second, if you're somebody that's creative, do something creative every single day, every day of your life. It's okay. I give you permission. Do it. Something, whether it's just, you know, writing a page, whether it's drawing a picture, whether it's recording a voice, whether it's taking a picture with your phone or filming a video or whatever you do that's creative and artsy and fun, writing a song, do it. Just do it every day. Even if the one you do that day stinks and isn't that great, keep doing it, you know, because that is what keeps you in it. And it keeps you against the book, The War of Art, not The Art of War, but The War of Art. Great book. I recommend it highly. And he talks about resistance. And there's that Stephen Pressfield. Yeah. Talks about the resistance is against us. You know, for me as a Christian, I would say it's the enemy that comes against me and tries to say, no, you don't want to do that. And I say, do it. Okay. Get out there and do something creative. Today, that's your goal. That's your thing. That's what the James Arnold Taylor Podcast, the JAT Fellowship, is asking of you in return for listening to this show today, is to do something creative with your life. All right. Now, you may have noticed, if you've gone to my YouTube channel and stuff, I took the comments off of everything. I've took monetization off of everything, pretty much everything. But, you know, crazy enough, YouTube still puts ads all over everything. So I apologize for that. I have no control over that now. Now YouTube can put ads on anything they want. YouTube, I know you're all listening and tracking everything. I'm asking, maybe you consider, you know, not... You know, giving people, if they say no monetization, it'd be great if it wasn't monetized then for you guys. Because... you want to be able to give people something commercial free. I just want to be able to give somebody the podcast. I'd like the podcast to just be commercial free for people. So that's all I'm asking. If you listen to this on YouTube, you are probably going to have to deal with commercials. If you listen to this on iTunes or Spotify or any of the other places where you podcast, then you're not getting those commercials. So, you know, maybe that's the solution for this. One thing that I like to keep commercial free is to listen to it someplace else besides there. But you know, I like putting my stuff on YouTube as well there for you because many people listen to it there and find it there. So either way, I'm saying it's all cool, but it's just, it's a bummer because I don't click the monetization button on it, yet I'm finding that there are still ads on this, and that just bums me out. But whatever, that's their system. They got to make money, I guess. So there you go. But I don't remember what I was going to say. Okay. Yes, I do. So I don't have a place. So I took comments off and I'm not really on Twitter anymore at all. I still have my Twitter account. That's me. It's still there. It's verified, but I'm not on it much. I'm on Instagram now pretty much exclusively. That's its own kind of beast. And you know, you can't get verified on it. If anybody knows how to get verified on Instagram, I'd say let me know, but how are you going to let me know? No, I guess you could let me know on my Instagram account. You can tell me there. Because, boy, I'll tell you, and you know, it's not like I care on one hand, but the only thing is I like people to know that that is my officially me. And that's just the kind of nice thing. But anyways, Instagram, a little snooty there, aren't you? Yeah, I mean, I have sent in that form so many times, and I can't tell you how many voice actors I know that have, and they don't care. You got to give them like your license and stuff too. That's like really personal information you have to give them. And then they just choose, nope. And then, you know, hopefully someday they don't get hacked and then all my info is there. But, you know, whatever. What are you going to do? Okay. So I'm going off on a tangent. But anyways, there is no place right now for you all to email me anymore. I took that off of my website. I needed a break from all of it. I've needed a break from all of it for this last year. And quite frankly, I was also overwhelmed. There's just so many of you wonderful people and so many of you wonderful people asking me things and emailing me. And I love it. And so please don't be offended by that I don't have it anymore. It's just, I'm such a, I take it all in and I want to reply to everyone. And I was literally getting so many emails that I couldn't, hundreds and hundreds every month, I couldn't keep up. And so at this point, I'm trying to keep it down to just one place where you can reach out to me and ask questions, and that would be on my Instagram account. So you can ask me questions there. I try to answer them, you know, within the things there, but I also will try to answer them here. So maybe what I'll do is I'll post there every once in a while and say, hey, if you have a question for me for the James Arnold Taylor podcast, then put it right here. And that's probably how we'll start doing questions from now on. I'm just figuring this all out right now as I'm talking to you. So I'll get Bob in. Hey, Bob. Hey, Bob. Bob is the guy that answers our comments and questions.
Oh, yes, James. Oh, hello. Yes, well, it's wonderful to talk to you again. It's been a long time, and I sound very good and different on this microphone here in the new studio, in the Jad Studios.
Yeah, that's the SE Electronics 2200.
Oh, yes, no, in doobity-doo and doobity-doo. Yes, I heard about that, yes.
So, anyways, Bob, I think we'll do, like, Instagram things for questions and answers and all from now on. Does that sound good?
Oh, indefinitely, indubitably, yes, yes, it does.
Okay, good. So that's what we'll do. So from now on, we'll set that up here in the next few episodes. And so you'll get, if you follow me on Instagram, and if you don't follow me on Instagram, maybe you need to follow me on Instagram. That would be Jat Actor, J-A-T Actor on Instagram. And you can follow me there and you can ask me questions in the comments. And especially when I post a comment or a video or a post saying, hey, I'm going to be doing questions. Okay, you get it. Okay, I'm rambling at this point because I'm delirious because it's almost 2 a.m. and I'm recording this. What am I doing? Oh, I'm crazy that way. And I'm going to go to bed soon, but I just wanted to get this out. So thank you all. Thank you for listening to the James Arnold Taylor podcast. Thanks for sticking with me. Please come back and listen more. Please do me a favor, would you? Would you spread the word about this show and tell people to listen to all the other 51 other episodes? You can catch up. Somebody discovers the show. If you're new to the show, guess what? There's a bunch more episodes. Go back and listen to them. Find them. Figure them out. Listen to them. Go to my YouTube channel. Watch all the videos there. Go to my Rumble channel. I have exclusive videos on Rumble that aren't on my YouTube channel there as well. So you can find either one, you know, and check stuff out. and find me in those places. Listen to the stuff. You know, there's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of videos on my YouTube channel. And there's even a daily one based on my book, Jat 365, 365 Daily Inspirations for the Pursuit of Your Dreams. And it's a way to encourage you every single day. You could spend a year with me. You know, the new year is coming up. You could start in January. You don't have to, but you could. You could get the book. It's on Amazon.com. And you could buy the book. I think it's like $15. And then, and I get like, you know, 2 cents from that. It's like I get 2 cents, you know, from videos on YouTube. That's why I stopped monetizing. I was like, well, it's not worth it. I'm just going to keep putting the content out. But then, you know, anyways. So I don't get rich on that stuff. That's all I'm saying. And you can go and you could watch a video from me every single day. Look at that. You could spend your time with Jat. And I thank you for spending your time with Jat now. And so, Mr. Announcer Guy...
Yes, James, back again, man. Deja vu.
Well, not really.
Just saying, man.
Okay. So are you ready to close the show out with the big legal mumbo jumbo, as we call it?
Yeah, man, totally.
All right, do that legal mumbo jumbo thing that you do.
You got it, dude. Talking to Myself, the James Arnold Taylor Podcast is a production of Yumigo Inc., recorded at Jat Studios. Engineered, written, recorded, and produced by, you guessed it, James Arnold Taylor. All voices are parody and should be construed as entertainment only. All music and sound effects used with permissions and licenses through Backtracks, Digital Juice, Production Tracks, and Partners in Rhyme. James Arnold Taylor's Talking to Myself, the podcast. Copyright 2021. All rights reserved.
You do that so well, it's as if it was pre-recorded.
That's right, man.
Okay, everybody. Hey, thank you for joining me here on the James Arnold Taylor podcast. Thank you for listening to a very personal story and a lot of stuff there. And... please, again, spread the word about the show. Let people know that if they want to just kind of hear a person of faith talk about their faith and a person that is in the public eye talk about how it relates to them in the public eye and living how they live and doing what they do, well, then maybe this podcast is for you. If you want to hear somebody doing some crazy voices and talking to themselves and trying to have as much fun and entertaining as they can be, well, then, you know, spread the word. And there you go. It's just my little gig. It's what I do. I'm so glad to have you all with me here. We will be back with more episodes very, very soon. God bless you all. Please take care of yourselves. Please be safe out there. God bless you. God love you. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.